Step-by-step instructions to using the EB Complete Tamponade System. Step 1. Collapse balloon. Collapse the uterine balloon and wrap it loosely around the catheter for easier insertion. Stopcock should remain open to let the air out. Step 2. Insert. There are two methods to insert the uterine balloon, direct and indirect. The direct method is done by cupping the uterine balloon in your hand and inserting your entire hand through the cervix to the fundus. The indirect method is done by threading the catheter through your fingertips at the cervix into the fundus. Regardless of the insertion method, ultrasound guidance should be used to confirm proper placement. Step 3. Inflate uterine balloon. To inflate, ensure the stopcocks are closed and remove the cap from the spike valve. Spike an IV bag, or any kind of isotonic solution, and gently squeeze. You can also fill using the stopcocks and syringe if you desire. Step 4. Monitor fill volume. When inflating the uterine balloon, it is important to keep your fingers at the cervix to ensure the balloon does not distend into the vaginal canal during inflation. Begin with 250 milliliters and then fill incrementally according to your hospital's protocol until the desired fill volume is reached. Use ultrasound guidance to confirm placement. Step 5. Place vaginal balloon. Although optional, the vaginal balloon helps anchor the uterine balloon in place. To move, unlock the slider by pushing thumb clamp forward until you hear an audible click. The balloon will now move freely along the catheter to your desired location. Lock in place by firmly pressing down on the clamp. Fill vaginal balloon until it is tight in the vaginal canal. The vaginal balloon helps anchor the uterine balloon in place, reducing the likelihood of balloon expulsion. Step 6. Monitor drainage. Attach a Foley or graduated container to the drain port to measure blood loss and monitor continued bleeding. If needed, check drainage lumen patency by irrigating with a small amount of isotonic solution through the irrigation port. Step 7. Deflate and remove. Once tamponade is achieved and the patient is stabilized, open stopcocks to remove fluid slowly or titrate using a syringe according to your hospital's protocol. If rapid removal is needed or to ensure no fluid remains in the balloons, you may cut the tubes prior to removal. EB, Complete Tamponade System, by Clinical Innovations.